So we have now we will take the series reactions. So series reactions, our famous reactions are A going to R, R going to S, K1, K2. Just to prove that what kind of contacting is better for series reactions, like exactly what we have done for the parallel reactions. So what he takes is, he takes a beaker, okay, and then he puts in this all the, here it is only A, it can be also A plus B also. Okay, let us take to understand easily only A is there initial at time t equal to 0, and then he imagines that this reaction is happening in the presence of light. Okay, so with this solution is irradiated in the presence of by light. So he puts a bulb here. Yeah. Yeah, that is the bulb, where of course, yeah, this is the light. Oh, here you have to put filament also. Okay, good. And of course, there is also a stirring. Stirrer is moving there. Yeah, so this is one setup, and another setup also. He just imagines that we have same size beaker, stirring, but he won't put light here, but he will take a small amount of solution. This is the pump, then it goes through a small pipe. And here there is a glass, very small one. Yeah, okay. Yeah. So here you put the bulb now. Yeah. This is the bulb where again you have light. Yeah, okay. So the difference is that here we have a small amount of solution coming and the same intensity here also used, right? So then the solution is exposed to that light, whereas here the solution is exposed to this light, the entire solution is exposed, but here it is only small part. Okay? So now let us see, and here also it is A, here also A at time t equal to 0, right? Yeah. You have discussed this in your BTech? Some of you would have discussed, okay. Most of you would have not discussed that. So then what happens here, let us see. The reaction is happening in the presence of light, right? So when you switch on the light at time t equal to 0, after filling up and after stirring, then what will happen? Light will go and attack the entire contents. Okay. Then what is there maximum now at time t equal to 0? Which component? A is there. So then A is exposed, that means A is exposed to the light. Okay. And because of this presence of light, the reaction proceeds. Right. So let imagine afterwards, maybe after 30 seconds. So that means some R would have formed because the reaction is going on the moment you switch on the light. So after that, I have some amount of R and some amount of A, but because we are talking about immediate after 30 seconds or 45 seconds, which one will be more and which one will be less? A will be more, because I think not 100% conversion has not occurred there. A is more and then R is less. So that is why still A gets more light, because simply it is more there, right? So like that, you will have again next time period if you discuss, then imagine, then what happens again is that you will have again slightly more A and less R, but R composition is slowly increasing. after some time, maybe I think just values only after 10 minutes probably, you will have more R and less A. Now, the light, R gets more light, right, and then A gets less light. This reaction is still going on, but this is started reacting to S. So, like that with more and more time when you analyze, finally, A will be everything converted, then R also will be converted to S. So, you will be left with only S in the system. Okay? So, that means, when I plot this C versus time, with the time only what you are plotting, okay? Then you have A, this is C A naught decreasing like this, correct? No? And this is C A, and R we know initially it is 0, right? Then slowly some amount formed, then increasing, and it goes like this. Yeah. So, afterwards when more light of more light is going to only R and less light to A, then this will start decomposing more and more. So, then you will it will reach a peak point and then it goes down, right. But S will start, this is C R, and S will start slowly and then finally, it may reach, this is C S. If all A is converted to S, then you will not, of course, again you know only you will see this line, all other things will become 0. That means, at the end you know finally, when you allow it for completion, because it is not reversible reaction, it is only irreversible. So, finally, you may reach for a long time if you wait only C S. So, that means, this is the one, and our interest here is R, R is the desired product. So, now we have to find out what is the time that is maximum C R you get, and beyond that we should stop the reaction. Okay? So, this is one way of operating the system, and you get this kind of concentration profiles. Yeah.
In the case of C R, why it is not still decreasing? Because R will be decomposing, right?
R will be decomposing.
But why it is more than C A, it will fall down.
No. All three at any point of time, all three must be same. Not same. Huh? All three should satisfy this relation. If I take pure A, this is valid at any point of time. If I take at this point, all three concentrations must be this concentration. Okay. So that is there. I mean, it may not be exactly to scale. So that's why somewhere you may not get that kind of thing. So, but all three must be satisfying this condition, C A naught equal to C A R and all that. Okay? Good. So, now if you go to this setup, now what will happen? Let us see. It started now at time t equal to 0, you switched on this and then pump is running and switched on this light, and when you switched on this light, the intensity is same, but here amount of liquid is more and here amount of liquid is less. So, that means, in the presence of highly intense light, then this will be practically going to completion of the reaction. What is the final completion of the reaction? S only. Okay? Yeah. So, that means, there may be small amount of R may be there, but essentially it goes to S. Then that will come back here and again you are taking out, and when it is coming here only S is coming inside, right? And then you have again practically more A only. Again, A will come here when you are recirculating, and same amount of A, small amount of A will come, goes here, getting reacted, and again S coming there. Okay, right. So, under these conditions, how do I plot these concentrations? C versus time again, right. What will happen to C A? This is C A naught, that is decreasing anyway. This is C A, and what will be A, sorry R? R will be maybe very very small, like this it may be. This may be C R, that means practically you do not see much concentration of R inside the here inside this reactor, okay? Yeah, they are inside this tank. and S will be going on. Finally, at this point it has to go, yeah, maybe beyond this it will go to C A naught, where again all three must be equal to 0, right. Okay. So, what is that lesson what you learn here? This is C S. What is the one? What is that we have done in this case, and what is done we have done in this case? Yeah, here what we are doing is, we are now just leaving the concentration on its own and just waiting for the reaction to occur in the presence of light anyway, okay, right. This is one kind of contacting, but here what are you trying to do? You are now trying to do here a stream you are mixing with a different composition of A, correct, no? I mean, here practically there is no A. Everything is converted to either R or S, but mostly S because intensity is very, very high. That means, here two different concentrations are mixing, streams of two different concentrations are mixing. That means, this is not a stream here, this is already there, and then you are sending this stream into this with a different concentration, whereas here you simply allow the system for the reaction to take place. Okay? So, if you want your R as the product, which system is better for you? The first one. So, that means, what you have to do? To maintain this R high, what is the kind of system what you choose? Reactor. Now, you come to our reactors, which reactor will maintain this kind of condition, which reactor will maintain this kind of condition? This is PFR, or another alternative? Batch. Either batch or PFR will give you A going to R, R going to S, S R is maximum when compared to a mixing flow reactor, where you have some reaction going on already, you have some concentration which is different than the fresh liquid which is entering, correct, no? The fresh liquid which is entering, that is C A naught, and it is mixing with the liquid which is inside the tank, whose concentration is at the outlet concentration of the all the components. It may be S, it may be R, it may be A. So, that is what exactly we do here. That is why here you do not get much R. So, do not use mixed flow reactor if you want to get more R. Okay? So, this is a wonderful thought experiment, that means this is true everywhere. So, whenever you have an intermediate, in fact, it is not only here, I can also put T. If you want intermediate this and this, you go only for this one, not this one, okay. And chlorination of benzene is one of the very good examples for this, you know, benzene chlorination, where they have series parallel reactions, okay, or only series reaction, benzene chlorination, monochlorobenzene, dichlorobenzene, trichlorobenzene, they are not parallel, I think they are series, yeah, series, that is one of famous example where lot of information also is there, industrial information is there in that. Okay? So, this is the rule. Now, let us record that rule, so that you will remember that. You have drawn these figures, no? Both the figures? Very good, yeah. Yeah, you can write now, just below that, you know, in the first beaker, you can write this one as first, this is second beaker. In the first beaker, the contents remain homogeneous throughout, all changing slowly with time, whereas in the second beaker, the reacted fluid is continuously being mixed with fresh fluid. Okay? That is correct. No, this is fresh. This is always at C A naught, right? And then you are now bringing another stream with a different concentration, maybe a little bit of R and mostly S. Okay? Good. Yeah. So, full stop there. In other words, we are mixing two streams of different compositions. Okay? Now, the general rule you write just below next para. For reactions in series, the mixing of fluid of different compositions is the key to the formation of intermediate. Full stop. The maximum possible amount of any and all intermediates is obtained if fluid of different compositions and at different stages of conversion, fluid of different compositions and at different stages of conversion are not allowed to mix. That is the rule law, right? I do not know, maybe without understanding you would have just taken down, right? You just go through once more. For reactions in series, the mixing of fluid of different composition is the key to the formation of intermediate. Okay? How do you mix is important there. The maximum possible amount of any all intermediates, it need not be only one intermediate, it can be even, you know, one more, but all these intermediates when you want, okay, the maximum possible amount of any and all intermediates is obtained if fluid of different compositions and at different stages of conversion are not allowed to mix. So, just leave it on its own. Okay? Good. So, next para please write. Based on this, we can say that batch operation and PF, batch and PF, no operation not required, batch and PF should give you a maximum R because there is no mixing of fluid streams of different compositions. On the other hand, MFR should not give a high yield of R because a fresh stream of pure A is being mixed continuously with an already reacted fluid in the reactor. I think this is clear, no? This I do not think you will forget also, because you can just remember those two things and then always remember that for series reactions, if the intermediate is one of the desired components, right, then do not mix the streams, just allow either in like in batch reactor or like in plug flow. Plug flow you are just making them enter and then just you are collecting at the end, you are not interfering anywhere. Whereas, in mixed flow you have reaction going on and continuously you are putting fresh, okay, that is stirring at very high speed, and that means you are mixing two different compositions which will not give you very high intermediate conversions, intermediate concentrations for intermediates. Okay, good. So, now let us check that what we have learnt through small diagrams like this, which contacting pattern will be better. Okay. So, shall I write here or? Yeah, I think you take this and then afterwards I draw. Which contacting pattern of the following figures, next para you write, example otherwise, example. Which contacting pattern of the following figures can give a higher concentration of any intermediate, that is you write left or right, because I am going to draw two figures now, left and right. So, that is why left will have here right. So, one contacting pattern is this, that is simple PF. Our reactions are this, A going to R, R going to S, maybe T also. Okay. So, right is, so that is the kind of contacting pattern, that means either left or right, which one is the better. So, B is PF. With recycle where R equal to 1. And here I have two tanks in series. Okay. Yeah, another one is C where I have two tanks in series. Yeah, but the feed is distributed like this, and in this case, yeah, in this case, this is simply like this. Good. That means between this and this, which is better? So, D is, this is a simple pipe, but laminar flow. And here also I have left side a pipe. That is turbulent fluid inside moving. Okay. So, now we have to just discuss very simple things only. Which contacting pattern is better to get the intermediate? Like let us say R is our product, what we want. Yeah, so the first one is left is right, huh? Left is right. Okay. Nike. Nike symbol, huh? Tick. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is one. Left is right. So then the second one?
Left is right.
Left is right. You say right is right.
Yes,
sir. Why? How many tanks you require for almost plug flow? Yeah. So how many you have there?
Two.
Yeah. And of course, you can also ask me, sir, what is the recycle ratio?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that is 0 to infinity. Right? But what we feel is R equal to 1 is near to plug flow. Then this one near to plug flow. Yeah. When compared to this one near plug flow, so this one again left is right. Okay. Now what about this one?
Right.
Now right is right.
Right.
Correct. Now Abdul, you tell me why right is right.
Left is right,
sir.
Oh, that's why you said. Why left is right?
So because we are having a CA not is, we get in two different.
What is our rule?
To maximize R. R of S. So that is the.
No, maximize the rule.
Intermediate.
To maximize R is not the rule. What is the rule? Oh, you remember only word things, huh? Okay, anyway, no problem. Yeah. Which one is the?
We should not allow the intermediates to mix, sir. That is the rule.
Yeah. But is it happening here or is it happening here?
Serving the right.
Sir.
That intermediates, we should not allow them to mix. Not intermediates. I think the different streams of different concentration should not get mixed. Yeah.
Right.
Here.
Right,
you know, here we are again mixing the fresh one with some other concentration. Right, and here the fresh one with some other concentration. Okay, so that is why this is not right, but right is right. Okay, good. Huh? What Simi? You are Simi, no? I think between you again I am confusing. I think she is Neetu, right? You are Neetu. Ah, okay. Ah, Simi, you are laughing. What? Tell me. Tick. Okay, anyway. So next one? Right is right. Why right is right? Left is right. Dinesh, what is your name? Adinarayana. Okay. Adinarayana is Adi means beginning. So I think beginning Narayana is telling that, you know. Yeah. You say left is right. Okay. So you say right is right or left is right?
Right is right.
Pooja, center is right. why unnecessarily all the problem? Okay, somewhere in the middle. Okay, that's why I think this in Buddhism, Gautam Buddha always told that, you know, always better take a center path. Middle path, he says. Middle path is always safer. So the Pooja. Right is right. I am going to ask both of you why. Adinarayana, why you say left is right?
That
confusion has still not come.
Still there.
Yeah.
Right is right.
That confusion, that confusion has still not gone. The turbulence in plug flow when you say
high velocity.
Okay, we are talking about velocity profile. It is not the turbulence you imagine in the mixed flow reactor. That is, what do you mean? Now I am afraid to say chaos. Okay. So, this is the problem, you know. I do not know whether I told you this also. This also, you know, once you are aware of something, it is really a problem. This turbulent, I think Adinarayana, that is the one I think sometime back also when we were discussing PFR, some people came and asked, I think Merit, he came and asked me. Okay. So, when you are talking about the pipe flow and then turbulence, what kind of turbulence you are imagining there? It is not the turbulence where this molecule is coming and mixing here, right? No, in the actual pipe flow, when you say turbulent pipe, turbulent flow, what are the Reynolds numbers you are talking first of all? Yeah, about 10 to the power of 5 and all that. Okay, very large values. And what kind of, you know, the diagram you draw there to show the turbulence? You also draw that. Many times turbulence means what do you draw? You draw only like that. Correct, no? It is not, you do not draw like this, like this, like this, like this. Right? So, this will give me, this turbulence will give me almost flat velocity profile. Okay? I mean, this is very good. Actually, in fact, I do not know, you are not appreciating me. I have to only appreciate myself. Okay. Only for this reason, I have brought this example. It is there in the Levenspiegel book. Otherwise, this is a very simple one. I do not have to discuss that much. I expected that. Thanks for, you know, fulfilling my expectation. Okay, that I thought that, you know, this will happen. Some people still would may be thinking that laminar is, it may be better because there is no mixing here. Okay, but there is residence time distribution. When I have flat velocity profile here, what is the residence time distribution? 0. Whereas here I have the laminar profile where the molecule which is sitting on the top of it, it will come much faster, and molecules which are coming near the walls, they come late. We also have that you know, relationship, average velocity and then maximum velocity. Maximum velocity is, yeah, twice the average velocity, or otherwise half of the average velocity is half of the maximum velocity, right. So, that means if I take 10 minutes is the mean residence time, right. So, I will have molecules coming out 5 minutes afterwards. Till then you do not get anything, right. So, that is why this one turbulent means this is the one watch what imagining in a pipe flow where the turbulence is not from that end to this end. Okay? Those molecules are only going like this and then moving forward, and if I draw the velocity profile, almost it is like a flat velocity profile, but depending on the velocity you will see some slight bending near the walls. And in our imagination of plug flow, we are taking that also straight. Okay? That is why this is more near to plug flow. This one is more near to plug flow. That is why again right is right. Okay? Yeah. So, we have two lefts right and two rights right. Two. Okay? So, this is very simple scheme what we have, and then I think this is very nice simple things what we have. Now, I think it is your problem now. That means, I am just going to write the equations. You have to derive them. Some of them you would have already done in your BTech, because for simple scheme like A going to R, no, this one, A going to R, R going to S, you have already derived. Did you not derive what is CR max? Corresponding to that, what is T max? These are the favorite problems for gate examination and even other CRE examination. Okay? So, that is what again I am going to repeat, but later I think, you know, unless you work again once more at least, you cannot solve in the examination. Okay, good. That is what we are going to write now. So, now quantitative, this is qualitative analysis. Qualitatively, we have discussed what kind of reactor will give the best you know, product, right. Okay. Now, quantitative analysis. Okay. So, we have again same reaction K 1, K 2. Yeah. First, we have to write the rate expressions. So, R A, how do I write here? I can also write minus R A. Okay. Otherwise, R A equal to maintain the uniformity, some books write K 1 C A. This is equation 1. Okay, RR, yeah, Pooja, K1, K2, CR, that is equation 2, and RS, K2, CR, K2, CR, okay, this is equation 3. So, now, either batch or plug flow, because it is constant density system, batch or plug flow will give me the same equations, but you have to replace time by tau, that's all. Okay, please write there, time by tau, t r tau. Good. So now I think this is very simple to solve, because this is nothing but dca by, there is no minus, plus only, because minus I put there. So the first one will be ca by ca naught equal to e power minus k 1 t or k 1 tau if it is batch, if it is plug flow. Okay, good. So then cr by ca naught, but this is difficult for you, you have to do that. I don't know whether you have solved any problem using integrating factors and all that. How many maths course you had in BTech?
6.
Differential equation 4, differential equation is 1. You also had partial differential equations? Yeah, okay. I think that knowledge I think is required here. So here you will have k 1, k 2 minus k 1, e power minus k 1 t minus e power minus k 2 t. I think this bracket is there, right? Yeah. So this is 4. This is 5, and of course, C s will be, yeah, or C a naught minus, yeah, C a naught, otherwise I have to write, yeah, either that, I think someone told 1, that 1 you will get if I divide by C a naught. This is 1 minus C a by C a naught minus C r by C a naught. Okay, simply you can substitute these two, and then you get, this is the sixth equation, because now our interest is to find out the CR, and CR has a maximum problem, but whereas CA doesn't have that problem, it will go to highest if you just leave it, there is no optimization there. Optimization comes only for this, where I have to find out which T and which CR maximum. Okay. So that is why we have to now differentiate that equation 5. I think again I am requesting you, you have to practice CR by CT. Ah, that's right. Equation is not valid for k 1 equal to k 2, that is very good. This is only for k 1 not equal to k 2, right. But you know, this equation is also valid if you take the limits k 1, k 2, you know, that ratio you take, and then there is a mathematical derivation also for that. But safest is k 1 equal to k 2 equal to some k, and then solve the differential equation, you will get the simplest one. Okay. By the way, that is one of my favorite problems in the examinations. Already gave a?
Assignment.
Oh, assignment already given. Yeah, you see, either assignment or examination. So, I think you know, that is why only mathematics. Thank you for reminding. So now this we have to differentiate. So once we differentiate this, what you get, CR by C, okay, I will write here, CR by CA naught max, okay, max, I think CR max I will write. Equal to, yeah, some of you may be remembering this, K 1 by K 2, yeah, K 2 by to the power of k 2 by k 2 minus k 1, to the, this is to the power, please remember. So this is again not valid for, yeah, so this is equation number 7, and corresponding to this T max, corresponding to this T max is, yeah, very good, that is ln k 1 or k 2 by k 1 divided by k 2 minus k 1. So this is equation number 8. If you want you can arrange in the other way also. Okay. So these are the things there, and the concentration profiles and all that, you know, it will be similar to this only, those concentration profiles. So that is why whenever you have that maxima problem, then we have to find out through differentiation, what will be the corresponding value. Okay, good. Now, we will write the same thing for mixed flow. I think mixed flow is a very nice guy, it will not trouble you that much. MFR, yeah, okay. MFR we can write, you know, like the material balance, like we have written earlier. For the other one, we have written here also. We can write the material balance. So here again, we take normally C naught only. C R naught equal to 0. C s naught equal to 0. Here I have C A, C R, C S and volumetric flow rate V, volumetric flow rate V. This is V and we can also write, of course, in terms of F A naught and all that. Okay. So, for A material balance, yeah, again I will write so that you know it will be practice for you. V C A naught equal to V C A plus minus R A into V, where this minus R A can be written as, in this case, K 1 C. Yeah, K 1 C into V. So, from this equation 8, 9, 10. So, then we can show this as C A by C A naught equal to 1 by 1 plus K tau, where tau equal to volume by volumetric flow rate. So, this is 1. Similarly, I think R, let me write for R, M B for R. So, we know this is 0 entry, V C R naught, which is 0, equal to V C R minus R R into V. So, this is equation number 12. And if you substitute for this R R, this one, okay, and C also you will get there. Yeah, this is V C R equal to R R R R into V. Okay. So, R R if I also equal to R R, if I substitute this equation, this is K 1 C A minus K 2 C R into V. Or C R equal to K 1 C A minus K 2 C R tau. So, this is equation 13. Yeah. So, I can write, of course, I am not giving all the steps there. The final step C R by C A naught. Yeah, K 1 tau by 1 plus K 1 tau into 1 plus K 2 tau. Yeah, this is the equation. This is 14. Again, C s by C naught also we can write. Let me write this time equation K 1 K 2 tau square whole thing divided by 1 plus K 1 tau 1 plus K 2 tau. Yeah. So, this is 15. We have now other problem like this one, maximization, right. These are the standard nice beautiful problems. So, this I have to get now C R max, maybe I will remove this. Some of you may be remembering also this one. Yeah, nice equation, CR max by CA naught equal to 1 by K 1 by K 2 this is square. This is equation number 16. Yeah, corresponding tau max, no, tau optimum we will say, not max there. This is max, this is optimum. K 2 K 1 square root. So, this is equation 17. Okay. So, I think you have come with calculators, no? Can you tell me what is the PFR maximum and CSTR maximum, that CR max in PFR, if I have K 2 equal to 1 and K 1 equal to 2. Find CR max or CR max by C A naught if K 1 or K 1 K 2, okay. For PFR and MFR and the corresponding types. Corresponding taus. Corresponding taus. Okay. Good. So this is the one. Yeah. What will be the value? This one is straightforward, no? This is square root of 2, huh? 1 by square root of 2. Okay. So first write MFR, which is easy. Yeah. What is CR max by C A naught?
171.
Correct? 171. Okay, and tau max? Tau optimum, not max.
0.7077.
Okay, yeah. What are the units? Mean units I have not told. So when I have to give here units. This is minutes inverse. Second inverse or minutes inverse. Okay. So this will let me say 2 seconds inverse. 2 seconds I think very fast. So minutes inverse. This is also minutes inverse. So this is minutes, huh? So what is for PFR?
0.5.
0.5,
sir. CR max.
PFR CR max by CA naught equal to 0.5. Correct? And tau?
0.693.
Excellent. This again just to give you an idea that, you know, when you have this kind of thing, PFR will give you more yield, CR max, and also time also is less here. Time also is less here. Okay, good. So the next one, series parallel, I will just touch and then what also discuss now, series parallel, not much. I think I will not give you much work for series parallel because it is more mathematical, but only thing is you have to go through that equations. Okay, yeah, that is the one, and afterwards we will discuss a little bit about Dilby and Van der Fosse. I will give the actual references. If someone is interested, started liking reaction engineering, they have to go to original papers and then see. Okay, but I can give derivations in the examination also about this, simple derivations like find out CR by CA naught, even in DIN-B in some simple cases. Okay, good. So this is the one. I think again this will prove our rules where we should not mix streams and all that. Now when I told you, the concepts part is over, right? So now it is only hard work part, sweating. The thought experiments have gone. So now you have to go to laboratory and then work. So that's what. Well, you have to go home and then start deriving all these equations. So that is the hard work part. Okay. By the way, how many hours you are spending in on CRE every day? Zero. Every day 2 hours. Every day 2 hours is excellent if you are able to do. Sushmita is spending, I think, every day 27 hours. Okay, I think she stretches the clock and then goes to 24 to 27. Okay, see, discipline wise, every day 2 hours, 2 hours, 2 hours, if you do, I think you are doing wonderfully well. You will do also in the examinations. Rahul.
PMR, it is 0.25.
I don't have an answer, I am just giving you.
0.25.
Yeah, okay. Abdul.
Which one, sir?
PFR, he says 0.25.
K2 is 1, K1 is 2, right?
2 only, 0.5 only, sir.
K1 is 2 and K2 is 1.
K1 is
0.5
square.
K2 1
is
1.
Yeah, check Rahul. Otherwise, they will come and hit you. Anyway, please check that also. Yeah. So now we have series parallel reactions. And normal scheme, what we have is A plus B going to R. R plus B going to S. Okay, and this also can be represented in terms of series and parallel. How do you write as series? A going to R, R going to S. Here I have plus B, plus B. In parallel scheme, okay. See, here surprising thing is, I think there is another thought experiment. I think we do not discuss that, but only we believe that the experiments are right. And then see, whatever rules we have applied for parallel and series, they equally applied to even series parallel reactions. What is the rule for parallel? If I have a desired reaction with a higher order, you should have higher concentrations, maintain high concentrations. And in the case of this series, we have to now say that do not mix the reactants, but just allow them to react on their own. Okay. So, the two rules are again applied for these two, but it is not that easy. Our mind, I told you, someday I think I have thrown some 10 check pieces and asked you how many. So, beyond that, our mind may not accept. So, that is why what you have to do here is, every time a problem is given, you have to solve the problem. That means you have to mathematically write all the equations and then get the solution. Oh, if it is CR by CA naught or if it is CS by CA naught. Okay. Normally, this is the desired product. Normally, that is what our convention. Okay. Why, Sushma, you have headache? Under tension? Okay. Yeah. So, this is the one, and we will try to write the equations first for this one. That means, again, some students may not be knowing also how to write RA, RR, RB and all that. Okay. So, that is why we list out all the reactions. I think when you next do DIN-B reaction, there definitely you have a lot of possibilities. All the reactions, at least list out all the reactions, and then we will take whatever is possible to write the equations. But I think again, the plug flow and batch, you always go to integral expressions. You have to go to, you know, you have to integrate them. Okay? But if you go to mixed flow reactors, then there is no integration. Correspondingly, you have to substitute what is minus RR or RS or minus RA, minus RB, and then try to get the corresponding concentrations. Right? So, the overall picture is that, okay, depending on which reactor you are talking, you have the equations. That is why I told you, you do not have to learn anything new, because the same design expression is only valid here. You also seen for parallel reactions what we did, right? And even just now, yeah, even these things also we removed that, mixed flow, when you are writing equations for A going to R, R going to S also, the same design expression. So, as far as design is concerned, that is why I told you, it is very, very easy to remember contacting in the diagram. It is a long time I have drawn the diagram, I think it is sometime I have to draw again, otherwise you may forget. Okay? So, that is why actual part is, difficult part is only reaction part. You can also see now, particularly when you have multiple reactions, it is a challenge. How do you get all, you know, all these rates, like, let me draw that and then you will see. How do you get RR, RS, RA, RB and all this? It is not that easy to get all the constants. That is the real challenge. Okay? So, now when you are writing the rate equations, RA, I am writing only everything RA, RB like that, so that minus also will go this side. dCA by dT, if it is a batch reactor, equal to K1 minus, I think, maybe I will remove this. We will write general equation. K1, yeah, can you tell me? Minus RA.
K1 CACB.
And fortunately, we are not taking any reversible reaction. If you take reversible reaction, margaya. Okay. Again, I think, you know, the other term, back term will come and then your integration will be hell, all that. Okay, good. So, continuation, where are the 17, 18? Okay. So, RB. RB equal to, first it is participating here, yeah, minus K1 CACB minus K2 CRCB. This is equation 19. Excellent. Now, RR, yeah, K1, it is forming K1 CACB, and again it is, excellent, CRCB. So, this is 20. Then RS. RS is a nice guy at the end. It is like, you know, lost brother or lost sister. Least affected for many things. Correct, no? The smallest guy in the house, whether sister or brother, you will leave them. They are on their own most of the time. Okay. So, RS is like that. Very nice. Yeah. What is RS? K2 CR CB, CB. Okay, so this is equation 21. Yeah. K2. Okay. So, this is definitely complicated when compared to our series alone and parallel alone. From here onwards, you have to really think how to solve the problem. There are no simple rules of integration or simple rules of differentiation. Okay? Why I am saying that is, then you know, sometimes, yeah, you have to get the relationship between, okay, like one example I will tell you. I have now here CA, CB, CR, three are there here, right? But I have to convert into this one into only one component, either CB, okay, mostly CB only. So, then only I can solve that. That means, you have to now find out what is the relationship between CA and CB, and what is the relationship between CR and CB. That part is difficult part there. So, to get that part, what you have to do sometimes is that you have to manipulate these reactions to get, I think I will remove this. Yeah. So, we have to manipulate something like this, like only remove the time, okay. Remove the time variable, for example. That means, okay, this I also told you, okay, if it is a batch system when you are taking, this is nothing but minus DCA by DCA by DT. This is DCB by DT, this is DCR by DT, this is DCS by DT. Okay? Good. So, our idea is to get some of the relationship between these, you know, few expressions, like to eliminate one of them, like for example, CA, CB, and if I want to express all this in terms of only CB alone, like that here, it is only in terms of CR alone. So, for that kind of thing, you have to like RR by RA. What is the relationship? That means I have here DCR by DCA, negatives we have brought this. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Now, this equal to, tell me. So, Pooja is very good, I say, I think without writing all thought experiments. No, good, good. Pooja, like that only you have to do. If you are able to imagine everything in the mind, nothing better than that. Minus 1 plus CR by CA. Okay? Yeah. So, now to get a relationship between CA and CR, I have to integrate this. Correct, no? I have to somehow find out CR term separately, CA term separately, and then I have to integrate. Right? This is a differential equation. As far as possible, it need not be always DCA by DT. Right? So, that is why here DCR by DCA, this is also a variable for me. This is a variable in terms of CR I have to find out. So, that will give me the relationship between CA and CR. Right. So, now one relationship I will give, that means this differential equation has to be solved. Why I am telling all this? Probably now you know you stopped listening to me after some time. Okay. Now again, that is why please I think another maybe 15-20 minutes, I think Denby reactions also will finish. Okay. Yeah. So, we are doing all that because finally, we have to get the relationship between these concentrations, like in this also I have CR and CB and CA. So, I have to convert this entire equation into one concentration possible, okay? And this also similarly. So, that is why you have to look at all these equations and then see which one will give you that kind of relationship. Like if you solve this, what you get is CR by CA naught equal to integrating, what is the number? 22. Okay, let me also write here integrating equation 22. Yeah, what you get is CR by CA naught equal to 1 by 1 minus K2 by K1. CA by CA naught K2 by K1 minus CA by CA naught, which is only valid for K2 by K1 not equal to 1. Okay? So, this is equation 23. And CR by CA naught equal to CA by CA naught. There was some mistake. CA naught by CA log. Yeah. So, this is valid only for K2 by K1 equal to 1. So, this is equation 24. You see, this gives me the relation between CR and CA, if K2 is not equal to K2, this one is k2 not equal to k1, and this one is k2 equal to k1. See, now it's too much mathematics now, that's all. But again I tell you, too much mathematics, they are not really too much mathematics. It is only mostly first order differential equations. So you have various techniques, no, to solve this. You have integrating, what is that, integrating factor. So what are the other methods? That's all what we know, nothing else. Not partial, these are all straightforward ordinary differential equations. Variable separable, then? Yeah. So all the techniques only you have to use that here. Okay? Again, I am repeating, that is only to get the relationship between two components. Right? So that is what. So like that we have to solve this and then try to get, in fact, it has been solved, and this kind of reactions. So this is K2. This kind of reactions, and then the lot of information is available in any textbook. And Lewenspiel is again, actually it is not Lewenspiel, even before Lewenspiel, I think there are some German people who have done this, you know, actually that graphs. Lot of graphs are available for the relationship between CR, CS, CB, CA in one graph. Okay? Given if it is a continuous reactor, I think it is expressed in terms of K1 tau or so. K1 tau is the Damkohler number for first order, yeah. That is one. In terms of reactor volumes is one. The other one is plotting CR by CA0 versus CA by CA0. Okay? CR by CA0 versus CA by CA0. CA by CA0 will give us what is the conversion. Correct, no? And for that corresponding conversion, what will be CR by CA0, which depends on K1, K2 values. Of course, it also depends on CB values. CB naught and all that. So, these are the variables. So, you are now increasing more and more variables because you have more complicated equations. So, that is why you will go to multiple reactions more and more, but it will be more and more mathematical techniques. Good? Okay. So, that one I think kindly go through that, and I will give only as far as possible in this section is concerned very simple things, because I think I do not want to pain you also too much with this, but I think again I can tell you. Actually, this is what is more interesting in industry, okay? Because there is no simple reaction A going to R anywhere, but in university always we start with A going to R. Luckily, we are not talking about zero order, because there is nothing to talk about zero order. So that is why, because independent of concentration, any reactor is okay. So even if you put all those things in your pocket also they react, okay? So that is why we are not talking anything there. So that is why this multiple reaction, this is where I see the awkward phase of CRE, awkward phase. Why it is awkward? Because our brain has to work. So that is why we feel it is troublesome, oh my god, too much mathematics. But those people who love mathematics, tremendous amount of information, your passion can be put in these solutions. That is why that Van der Fussier was the first person to find out for various conditions what could be the CR max there, that yield max. Denby is another person, okay? These two. And there are again few more reactions, which I mean these are two are very famous most of the time. Okay? Now quickly shall we go to Denby reaction? I think it's not, it won't take much time. Correct, no? I think you are able to get these points now, no? Why we are in multiple reactions beyond simple A going to R going to S, and also A going to R and A going to S. Those are the simplest schemes. Beyond that, it is only the mathematics that is required, rules are same, only you have to carefully integrate and differentiate for maximum and all that, but techniques are required for you, right? And slightly complicated like this, if you go, then you should be able to get, you know, to solve finally, you should have also a relationship between other components like CR, CB, CA, I mean CS and CA. Good? Yeah. So, now let us see Denby reaction. Oh, in fact, I have not written here. This is only for PFR what we have written. I mean, these things PFR. Okay? Yeah. So, the same equation, okay, this is PFR. Okay? I think that somewhere I have to mention. This one. Integrating equation to for PFR. Please write that. Otherwise, now onwards you may accept anything whatever I say. Whether it PFR, you will say yes, MFR, you will say yes. Okay, good. Yeah, that is the one. If it is mixture flow, what do you do with that equation? Pooja? Mixture flow is the simplest one. Then you are thinking. Huh? Not thinking. Yes. Tell me then. That is the simplest one, I think. Mixture flow. Rahul, top down, thinking. Is there integration in mixture flow?
Integration.
Then what is that DCA and DCR and DCA?
CR by CA.
That's all. That is deltas now. That is delta CR and delta CA. And what is delta CA?
Minus
CRF minus CR naught. CR naught equal to 0 here. Okay. And delta CA? It's not CA naught. It is again, the definition is only CA naught, you know. The definition is always CA, yeah, out and then in. Okay. So that's why it is the simplest one. That's why you don't have to really worry. That will give you very quickly the relationship between CA and CR. Okay. So that is why you can imagine now that if at all I give this mixture flow, I may give, because there is no integration. Very simple, straightforward. Okay. So that's why I think, you know, you can also write, for example, DCB by DCR by DCB. Correct, no? Then you will still get the relationship, right? Yeah. So that's why. Okay, good. Now Denby reaction, let us take. So that's why MFR. Please make a note of that. It will be deltas, because there is no integration there. Denby reaction. Yeah. This is again simple scheme where you have A going to R. R going to S. This is K1, K2. Oh, no. I think yes. I am using Lehmann-Spillet notation. This is T. This is K2. This is 4, K4, and this is U. Yeah. So this is 1, 2, 3. Yeah. 3, 4. This is the one. Okay. And here, most of the time it is taken as elementary reactions. That means, this, all these are first order reactions. Okay. So, what kind of concentrations I have to maintain?
Independent
of concentration. Then what is the variable? Next variable for us?
Temperature.
So, when we have the temperature, then activation energy E1, E2, E3, E4 will come. Denby reaction is very famous for that arrangement. Okay? Depending on E1, E2, E3, E4 values, E means activation energy values, what kind of temperature scheme now you put? There is no one temperature scheme. Like, you know, you cannot always use high temperatures. You have to use till some point high temperatures and beyond some point low temperature. That means you have to now reduce the temperature. So, somewhere you have heating, somewhere you have cooling. Okay? So, that is why I think when time comes, I will also just indicate, you know, and the rule is same. What is the rule? If the desired product has, if the desired reaction has more activation energy, then maintain the temperature as high as possible. That same rule only. But how do you put that? Depending on you, because you have four parameters here, E1, E2, E3, E4. So, whether E1 is greater than E2. Like one simple thing is E1 is greater than E2, greater than E3, greater than E4. What kind of temperature scheme you put? Huh? Already she gave the answer. Okay. So then the other one is the reverse. Okay. E1 is less than E2, less than E3, less than E4. Then what kind of temperature progress? Huh?
What
is the result? Result is R. Yeah, I think just think. I think there are possibilities, beautiful, and also you have, you know, that is simple, straightforward thing. E1 greater than E2, E2 greater than E3, E3 greater than E4. But there may be another combination, like, okay, E1 is greater than
E4.
Yeah, E2, but K4 is greater than K3. Okay, I mean not K3, E3 and E4. So, all combinations also are possible, because it is not in our hands, no. We cannot say that you reaction, you have only this kind of activation energy. If you are able to tell that, it is fantastic, but we are not able to tell that really. So, that is why rules are same. You have to believe me when I say that concepts you have already learned, because now temperature you should not forget, concentrations you should not forget. But in all these reactions where temperature, I mean concentration is not coming, it is independent because all they have the same order of reaction. But Van der Fuster reaction is not same order again, it is different order. One reaction is different order, another reaction is different order. There you have again concentration problem as well as temperature problem. So, that is why it is more complicated. In 1960s and all that, you know, it is a beautiful playground for chemical engineers. Football, I think, you know, wonderfully you can play cricket, football, anything you can play there, because there are so many wonderful problems, even though there are. But I think, you know, those people had really excellent way of solving the things, because that's the first time they were doing, you know, all these problems. But now with our more knowledge, more technology, more cell phones, more you know, pushing like this, pulling like this, tap like this, everything will work for us technology wise, but brain stopped working. All thought experiments have gone. That is why it happens. Whenever technology increases, brain takes rest. That is the problem. That is why whether technology is really good or bad, highly philosophical people will discuss that. Till what extent technology is really good. Entire world is obese, except Ethiopia and one more country is there, Somalia, only skin, okay, and only skeleton is there, okay, very sad. Except those parts, most of the population, now we have 7.5 billion or something, okay. I can tell you 7.3 billion are obese. Why? No physical work, no mental work. Correct, no? If you want to go and sit down in flight, that takes you. You don't have to walk. Okay, from here to again airport, go by car, no walking. Right? And our body designed only for walking and working, I say. Not for traveling by flights. Oh, really, it is not designed for that. It is only for working, hard work. When you do that, you will not have any, what is that, wrong, I am telling you. No, really, I think, you know, you have to work hard. So, then only I think your health also is very good, okay. Otherwise, what do you do except eating? What else we are doing, you tell me? Only eating, no, that's all. You come here and then you enjoy my drama and then go and eat. and go and eat in the tiffin, what is that, your mess. That's all, and then sleep. And tomorrow morning, Monday morning, when I ask you, sir, I overslept. Yeah, naturally, if you eat more, you will oversleep. Okay. Yeah, that's all what we are doing. That's why, you know, so many hospitals, so many doctors, if you want to avoid them, walk all the time. Okay. So, because as if we are saving this planet, I think we have designed cars, we have designed flights, we have designed cycles, we have designed many things, and we are destroying the planet indirectly, no? All these are only indirectly destroying the planet. If our brain is not there, then happily, like monkeys jumping here and there, and you know, you may have, we do not know whether they also may have IITs, we do not know, all monkeys, no, because we do not know their language. So, there may be a loudspiel there. In monkeys, there may be an Einstein who has really thought, you know. That is why there is a wonderful movie called Planets of the Apes. It is really a beautiful satire, you know, the other way. It is always we are paining them. Now, at least once in the movie, at least let them pain us, at least in the movies. That is a real beautiful concept again. That is the greatness of mind again, I can tell you. Okay. So, that is why we will just right now, actually, concentration scheme is not that great here, but it is only the temperature scheme which is really good one. But even then, we have to write the rate of reaction equations. And when I write R A only once, okay, of course, this K 1 and K 2, then I have here minus K 1 plus K 2 into C A, that is all, no? Yeah. And Lowenspiel nicely, his brain is excellent. He will write K1, because he knows how to simplify things, you know. K1 plus K2 together, he writes K1, 2 there. okay, because simply minus is there, minus is there. Okay, so now shall we continue or tired of so many things? I think no, I am talking about equations, not not leaving equations only. Okay, so R, what is next one? R, okay, R R, let me put. Okay, so R R is the desired product, then it will have k 1 C A minus k 3 k 4, yeah, what is that? C R. So Lebesgue language again, if I write k 1 C A minus k 3 4 C R, so this is equation 2, correct? No, I think this all of you got it, no, because it is only participating in k 3 k 4 and forming here. Pooja, R is formed in this reaction, that is k 1 C A, this is reacting, this is reacting, so minus C R. Okay, good. So then R S equal to see, I told you, no, youngest brother, youngest sister, k 3 C A, C R, C R, k 3 C R, this is equation 3. Okay, then C sorry R T, very good, k 2 C A, this is 4, and R U, very nice, you have earned your lunch, nicely told. Okay, I think few integrated expressions I will write for batch and batch and PFR. Okay, so anyway, beyond this we also have this material balance which is required for us, that is C A naught plus C R naught plus C S naught C T naught plus C U naught equal to all that again, C A C R C S C T C U. Okay, and of course if you don't have R 0 S and R, that will be 0, then it will be only C A naught, so that relationship is there. And for batch C A by C A naught, when I integrate this, you should guess it, no, what is the equation for C A by C A naught? By this time you should guess, yeah, no, something happened to Pooja, I say. Yeah, k 1 2 t r tau, I think tau t r tau. Okay, so this is what I think, this equation, this is 6, this is 7, yeah. So now c r by, I think here things are slightly complicated. Okay, so here let us take yeah, all these things are 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay, only we have pure component A. Okay, so now C R K 1 K 3 4 K 1 2 e power minus K 1 2 T minus e power, oh no, yeah, yeah, k 3 4, yeah, k 3 4 t, that's all, yeah. Do you can you have some comparison between this and then what you have done earlier? This is k 1 by k 3 4 k 1 2 exponential k 1 2 t minus exponential k 3 4 t, are right only, that is it is in series. Yeah, okay. So then C s by C a naught this is slightly complicated because this is coming at the end. So we have k1 k3 by k3 4 k1 2 e power minus k3 4 t by k3 4 minus e power minus k1 t by k1 2, right? Plus you have one more term here, k1 k3 by k1 2 k3 4. So this is 9. Okay. So normally our desired product is this. We can leave it there, but just to, I'm just writing the other things. You know how the how you get this. So then C t by C a naught equal to k 2 by k 1 2 1 minus exponential e power only I am writing e power minus k 1 2 t. So this is equation 10. And of course, C u you can get it C t r as minus of 1 minus of all those equations, correct? No? Yeah. So that you can write, I think that is C u by C a naught equal to 1 minus all this C r by C a naught C t by C a naught C r C t C s by C a naught and minus C a by C a naught. Yeah. So now one more thing here is that our idea is to integrate to get the maximum of this C r. Okay. So to get that maximum, we have the equation C r max by C a naught equal to k 1 2 k 3 4 to the power of divided by this is equation 12 and corresponding T max, not max actually, optimal or tau optimal for P of r So that is the one, because that is again similar to your series reaction, correct? No, exactly series reaction, but only thing is you have more constant that are involved there. So quickly now writing for MFR, this is very nice, simple. C a by C a naught equal to 1 by 1 plus k 1 2 tau, this is 14. C r by C a naught equal to k 1 tau 1 plus k 1 tau 1 plus no not k 1 tau this is k 1 2 tau this is k 3 4 tau. So So, in fact, you don't have to really worry about this, because these equations are similar to only A going to R, R going to S. Okay. So, the other reactions I do not want to write, I mean there are, but you do not want to write, but you can simply say C R max by C A naught equal to this one K 1 divided by K 1 2. Yeah, now this is K 3 4 by K 1 2. This is half plus 1, this whole thing is squared. So, this is 16. So, corresponding tau optimal equal to 1 by k 1 2 by k 3 4 to the power of half. So, this is 17, very good. Right. So, I think you know you do not have to worry that much even for examination, because the same similar things, you know, A going to R, R going to S only in Denby reaction if R is the desired product. I can guarantee that I do not go to any other desired product, R only I will ask if I ask. Okay. Yeah. So, the last one only just mention Van der Puste reaction. Oh, Denby reaction, I have not given the reference. So, we note down, I think, when first title Denby reaction, you write CES. You know what is CES?
Chemical Engineering Science.
Chemical Engineering Science. Okay, okay. I will write here Chem Inc. Science. Okay, normally we write like this, volume 19, I think maybe first time I have to tell you, okay, volume 19 and page, sorry, not 99, volume 8, page 125, year is 1958, okay, I was 10 years old at that time. Huh? No, that is normally we use starting page. Okay. So, yeah, yeah. So normally we give starting page. I think some journals will give complete pages. So then when you go, then only you will know how many pages it is. Okay. Yeah. This Van der Puste reaction, that is Chemical Engineering Science. This is volume 19. Volume 19, page 994, this is 1964. Okay. Actually, you see, again, that is a beauty there, 60s and till 70s, whatever problem they did, all of them are connected with industry. Afterwards only we lost touch with industry. There is a beautiful story, I think, you know, to lose that connection with industry, only one book is responsible. Can you guess that book? Transport Finance. That is the book which was responsible for chemical engineers to move away from the industry. Particularly chemical engineering means, you know, academic chemical engineering. Right? Because in that book what he has shown was, even in earlier it was thought that all engineering problems can be solved only by either experiment or empiricism. That is why you have so many empirical equations for heat transfer coefficient, mass transfer coefficients, all these things, even friction factors, all these things only empirical correlations, because they do experiment and then try to extend, scale up a little bit and then try to find out the correlation is valid. If it is not valid, they add some more terms when they go bigger and bigger. So, when 1962, when Bud Stuart Lightfoot came and then wrote this book, then all academicians thought that, my God, what is a beautiful idea, because I think all the problems can be solved in terms of differential equations, integral equations. It's wonderful, okay? Idea is wonderful, but we don't know how to use it. So that is why all academicians now started working only in problem solving, but not the problem formulation. But in industry, there was an existing problem. They have to solve that. But here, we will simulate our problems. So that is why we will say that, okay, one differential equation, 10 boundary conditions. Each boundary condition will give me one paper. It is paper publication only it became. It is not the solutions which we are providing to industry. It finally became, you know, paper publication number increasing. No challenging problems. Challenging problems in the industry, what I mean is, okay. So that is why then industry people, when they have a problem, they used to come to academicians. At that time, in before 60s and all that, perfect coordination between industry and university. When this book came and when we started solving problems on the paper and also using different techniques, for different techniques to solve the problems, when the industry person comes and asks the professor, then he will talk his own language. What is his own language? Matrices and vectors, tensors. That is our language, right? I think in thermodynamics, not thermodynamics, in transport phenomena, you will see this in next semester. Only vectors and tensors, okay? Then industry person ran away, because what is this vector tensor? I have never seen in industry, okay? Because he has not really seen in industry. Then they tried sincerely, maybe 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 30 years, and then they thought that, okay, now all professors are a separate breed, we are separate a breed, so now gap widened. So they stopped coming to universities and then they started their own industrial research, because they need, you know, there are some problems where in industry it may take time, it is not instantaneous solution you get it. So that is why let us have our own R&D in industry, so we will look into some long term problems. And much more long term, even then there was slight contact between industry and university, much more complicated problems which you can, they know that you cannot solve that problem, that problem only will be given to academic institution. They don't expect anything, okay, if something, no really, they don't expect anything, but if they give that problem, if a solution comes, very happy. If the solution comes, if the solution doesn't come, equally happy, no problem, no problem at all. So that is how it has gone, that one book which changed the minds of all chemical engineering academia, okay. Now only again we are thinking whether how far, how near we have to go to industry. It is really destroyed, because it is not the problem of the book, it is the problem of our mindset in the universities, because we would be happy in solving the problems, you know, on the paper, differential equations, using differential equations, all other techniques, rather than actually going to industry and looking at the problem and solving it. Actually, those problems also require these solutions. Solid, when you have, you know, I don't know whether you heard what is called SMB, simulated moving bed reactor. Highly mathematical, industry people are using that. Particularly Germany is very good in that. Simulated moving bed, highly programmed and highly controlled. You know, the simulated moving bed means, you know, the normal adsorption column, at one point they have four adsorption columns. One adsorption column will be, you know, maybe half filled up. You know, you have the adsorbent, it is a batch process, because adsorbent is in a packet bed. This packet bed moves now. It is not literally moving, but I think in the original laboratory it was literally moving also, right. So in one packet bed, you will have adsorption going on. In another packet bed, you have adsorption almost about to complete it. Then in another packet bed, you have the regeneration taking place, because you have to use the same packet bed again for regeneration, right. So and then in other packet bed, you have almost regeneration completed, then that becomes again fresh adsorbent bed. So all this is programmed, like you know how the beds move, or instead of beds moving, people thought that let us move the solutions where they are getting adsorbed. And this is widely used in the biochemical reactions, where they have the enzymes are formed already in the liquid, in the broth, they call no reaction broth, and then that reaction broth is pumped through these adsorbents, and adsorbents will have different adsorbents, not one single adsorbent. So, that means some adsorbents will take some enzymes, some other adsorbents will take some other enzymes, and then finally, of course, that elution will come depending on what part you take out and then do it. That is very, very complicated. You know, this is really high tech processes in biotechnology, really high tech, right? That is after fermentation, after the actual biochemical reaction, how do you separate the products? So, that is why even mathematics are really required in industry. And I think another example also, which I sent that paper, Pooja was asking me, that paper where you have Haber reactor and all that, chemical engineering science, not Free the World. There was another paper which I said, chemical engineering science paper, no? Where it's chemical engineering paper by that Winter Mantle, one person wrote. He was working in, I think, Bayer company or so, or Hoechst company, I think. Yeah. So, he has written a wonderful paper. I think if all of you are interested, I can send that paper. It is a wonderful paper, where how the chemical engineering started in Germany and then what they did and all that. So, at one point of time, he also involved in that. He first computer simulation of crystallization. Crystallization is another very, very difficult problem. It is very difficult problem if you want to get the type of crystals you want. Any kind of crystal, no problem. The crystallization is the simplest. I don't know, I think a long time back there was a Tamil movie called Kamalasan, Sridevi. Okay, these two people, I don't know, Tamil name is complicated, but it is Balachandra movie where they go to Delhi and then he does not know how to leave. The Sivapala something, it will come. Yeah, that is correct. Yeah, I think other people may not understand that anyway. So, in that movie, I think four friends are there. In Telugu, it is Akal Raj. Okay. In Tamil, it is the original. Okay. It is only, I think, dubbed there only. But you know, there is a wonderful dialogue where all the four friends are there. They cannot get jobs and they cannot live properly and all that. So, then the remaining three people will try to have whatever life they get. But this fellow will not allow that. I think he will always say that, okay, I want to have life only in this way. That is why he says beautifully, if you say, idealism, yeah. If I want to live like this only, I will suffer. But if I want to live like any other way, that means by stealing, by robbing, by murdering, all this also, that is way of living. Okay. So, when I want to do that, it is easiest because there are so many opportunities for that kind of thing. But if you want to really live like an idealist, there is only one way. That is why we say, you know, truth is only one. Truth is only one, whether you talk or I talk or he talks, truth is only one. But for all other people, truth is, I think, you know, when you want to tell lies, so then you can tell, you know, for the same thing, you can tell thousands of lies. Correct, no? You have not come to the class. Okay, how many lies you can tell? You can first kill your father, grandfather, okay, that is one lie. You can kill your grandmother, another lie. You can kill someone also, you know, where some relative, that is another lie. And also you can say that you have headache, another lie. And you may say that my leg was paining, sir, I cannot move, another lie. Thousands of lies for the same one thing. Truth is only one, sir. This is correct reason may be only one, you are sleeping. Yeah. But that is the problem. Okay. Yeah. Catch it is over. Huh? So, then what happens to my friend of Fuster reaction? Okay, next class, huh? Okay, we will close it. Only Fanta Fuster reaction will take it. Thank you.